Hey guys, and a very warm welcome back to What's For Tea. I'm actually making an apple and sultana crumble today. I'll be making 6 or 7 individual ones using the small foil trays you see right at the back there. A friend of mine actually isn't very well just now, so I thought it'd be quite nice to send some round to her. Usually I would just make one large one, so it's obviously up to you how you divide it up. It's super quick and easy to make and also super cheap. You'll probably find you've got most ingredients already, with the exception of the apples. That's usually the only thing I need to buy, but you only need 2 or 3, so I'll go on with the ingredients. So the first thing you're going to need is 200 grams of room temperature butter, a couple of handfuls of sultanas. You're also going to need 225 grams of soft brown unrefined sugar. You're going to need 1 pound, or which is normally 3 cooking apples, peeled, cored and chopped into bite-sized pieces. You'll also need 1 teaspoon of cinnamon and 300 grams of plain all-purpose flour. So the first thing you want to do is get your flour and your sugar into a bowl. You want to give that a good mix in, just so that everything's properly combined. So that's your brown sugar there, and also your flour. So like I say, just give it a good mix in, just like that. Okay, so once that's all combined, it should look like this. You don't want any big, you know, lumps in there, because it'll just burn, you know. Next, you want to pop your butter in. Just pop it in maybe 3 or 4 bits at a time, and just start sort of rubbing it in. Just sort of rubbing in is just where you lift the flour up and the butter at the same time. Just combine it with your fingertips till it resembles breadcrumbs. Now this takes a wee while, so just have patience, and this is what you'll have at the end. It'll take you about 10 minutes. You can also do it with a machine, but it works out, in my opinion, much better if you use your hands. So there we are, that's what it should look like. It's just like a thick breadcrumb, and it smells amazing. It smells just like treacle. That's with all the brown sugar, mind you. So that's what we're looking for, and that's what we've got. So now we're going to, I think we're moving on to the filling. Yeah, we are. So the first thing you want to do is get your fruit into the bowl. My apples look a bit brown, that's because I've been sitting a wee while now. So you want to, yeah, and then you want to pop in that tablespoon of flour you reserved from earlier, and also the 50 grams of the sugar from earlier as well. So that's what it should look like. You just pop your cinnamon on top of that, and then your sultanas on top of that. You only need two handfuls of sultanas, and that's what you've got. So you'll be mixing all this in together as well. Again, just give it a good mix in till all your apples are coated and all the cinnamon sort of throughout your whole mixture. You want it all sort of even, so that when you portion it up, you know, you're getting the same in every sort of dish. So that's what I'll be doing today, individual portions. But as I say, usually I just use the one bowl. That doesn't really matter in that case, but it does really if you're making individual ones. So that's just mix, 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 and keep mixing like I'm doing here. And this only takes a few minutes. How's your day been, guys? Mine's has been fabulous. There we are, that's us finished. So these are the wee dishes I'm going to be using. I've actually used these dishes before. They're a bit smaller than your sort of takeaway containers. Probably about half the size, actually. But this is what you do. That's the amount of mixture you want, really. You don't want them too full up. And try and leave some wee gaps down the sides, just as I'm showing you there. Because that way, when your crumble mix goes on top, like I'm showing you now, it kind of falls down the sides and combines really nicely. Because when you put it in the oven, a kind of syrup forms. And some of that crumble ends up into the syrup. And oh, it's so nice. It's absolutely delicious. And not for you if you're on a diet, obviously, which I should be actually thinking about it, but we'll not go there just now. So just keep putting your crumble on. So you don't want too much, obviously, just till it's sort of falling off the edge, and then you can stop. So that's me done one. So what I'll do is I'll do the rest off camera, and I'll pop back. So this is the filling being put in. That's what it should look like. As I say, you don't want to overfill them, because it's quite nice when you've got a wee bit more crumble. So it's sort of equal fruit and crumble, which is nice, and that's your crumble on the top. So this is them just before they go into the oven. So that you need about 45 minutes in gas mark 3 or 4, which is a long time, but just keep an eye on them. You'll know when they're ready. You'll know when they're ready when the fruit starts to bubble at the sides, and it's nice and brown on the top. So that's mine just going in. don't know what I'm doing there. I'm saying, what the hell am I doing? Well, never mind. So this is them just out of the oven and they're absolutely piping hot. Nice and golden on the top. The one at the back right there looks a bit burnt, but we'll just skip over that one. So yeah, so that's them just out of the oven. Give them about 10 minutes to cool down if you're going to be wanting them straight away. And that's what it looks like on the plate. You can obviously have whatever you want, ice cream or custard or whatever. I've just used some whipped cream in these ones. So yeah, so it'll be absolutely delicious and I'm sure she'll love them. So thanks very much for watching, guys, and I really do appreciate it. It means a lot. And I'll just leave you with a wee picture of Scotland. And I hope to see you again in the next one. Bye now.